Dear students, welcome to the part 2 of your module 5. So in this part we shall study some of the problems under joint distribution. The first example, the joint distribution of two random variables x and y is as follows. So the joint distribution table is given here with the three values of y and two values of x. First question, determine marginal distributions of x and y. Second question, covariance of x and y. Standard deviation of x and y, sigma x and sigma y. Correlation of x and y. Actually here correlation means they consider it as correlation coefficient. Okay. For expectation of xy, actually we use the name as correlation in statistics. But here correlation means they mean it as correlation coefficient. So only the final answers, rho xy is required here. Okay. So let us find the answers one after the other. First question, marginal distributions of x and y. I already explained you in the previous video how to find the marginal distribution of x. For example, for x equal to 1, these are x values. Remember, for x equal to 1, how to find the marginal distribution of x? We add all the values in that row. In front of x equal to 1, we add all the entries. That gives you p of x equal to 1, individual probability of x equal to 1. Similarly, we add the entries in front of x equal to 5, which gives you individual probability p of x equal to 5. These are marginal densities of x. How to find marginal densities of y? We add the entries column wise. So 1 by 8 plus 1 by 4, it gives you the marginal probability of y equal to minus 4. 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8, if you add these two entries, it gives you marginal PDF for y equal to 2. And addition of these two gives you marginal PDF for y equal to 7. So I am showing that procedure now. So p of x equal to 1, as I told you, in front of x equal to 1, these three entries we are adding and answer is 1 by 2. Similarly, p of x equal to 5, adding these three entries in front of x equal to 5, you get 1 by 2. And remember, when you have only two values of x, if one probability is known, other probability can be guessed. Why? Because if this is half, remaining probability should be half, so that total will be 1. That is the condition of individual PDF. Remember, sum of all probabilities equal to 1. For x values, sum equal to 1. Similarly, find the values, probabilities for the values of y. So which under minus 4, y equal to minus 4, add these two probabilities, 1 by 8 plus 1 by 4, which gives you 3 by 8. Similarly, second value of y equal to 2, add the probabilities, you get 3 by 8. And third value of y, 7, 1 by 8 plus 1 by 8, it gives you 1 by 4. And if you check the sum of all these three entries, 3 by 8 plus 3 by 8 plus 1 by 4, it will be equal to 1. You can verify it. And these individual probabilities are written separately in two tables. These are called as individual probability tables or marginal probabilities tables. So these are marginal probabilities. For x values 1, 5, corresponding probabilities are half each. And for y values minus 4, 2, 7, corresponding probabilities are 3 by 8, 3 by 8, 1 by 4. Now what is your second question? Second question is covariance of x and y. For covariance of x and y, we need expectation of x into y minus expectation of x into expectation of y, correct? So you need three expectations. So let us find out these expectations. Expectation of x is summation of xi into p of xi. Okay, now no need to refer your joint distribution table. It is enough if you refer the tables obtained in the previous slide, x values and y values. Okay. So expectation of x is x into p of x, so 1 into 1 by 2 plus 5 into half. Calculate it, you get 3. Similarly, expectation of y is y values into p of y values, summation of all such values. Substitute and check it. But which are y values? minus 4 into 3 by 8, 2 into 3 by 8, 7 into 1 by 4. It is written here. Calculate and check it. Answer is 1. So mu x is 3. Expectation of x is 3 and mu y is 1. Now expectation of x into y. Here we use both variables x and y. So we need to use joint distribution table. So p of xi yj is required. So summation of all xi yj into p of xi yj. Substitute from the table. How to select xy value and p of xy value? I'll show you the joint table once again. This table, x values are selected from the row, y value is selected from the column, and p of xy is the probability written in the corresponding intersection. So when x is 1 and y is minus 4, p of xy is 1 by 8. So it is 1 into minus 4 into 1 by 8, first term. Similarly, 1 into 2 into corresponding probability 1 by 4. Similarly, plus 1 into 7 into 1 by 8. And second row, x value is 5, y value is minus 4. So 5 into x into y into p of xy. So 5 into minus 4 into 1 by 4. Okay. 5 into 2 into corresponding intersection entry is 1 by 8. Plus 5 into 7 into 1 by 8. So this is the procedure to select the entries and multiply. I am showing you the multiplication step now. So how, I think you understood how to select these entries. Now multiply. After multiplying and adding, you get the answer 3 by 2. You can use your own procedure to multiply and add this. No need to follow the same steps. You get the answer 3 by 2. Now you have expectation of x into y, expectation of x and expectation of y. So that you can find the covariance. What is the covariance formula? Covariance of xy is given by expectation of xy minus mu x into mu y. Substitute, you get the answer minus 3 by 2. And third question, they asked you sigma x and sigma y, correct? Sigma x and sigma y, that means standard deviations of x and y. So first to find the standard variance of x and variance of y, then you can find the square root. What is the formula for variance of x? Expectation of x square minus mu x whole square, and variance of y is expectation of y square minus mu y whole square. Again, to use this formula, we need to find only expectation of x square first. Now, find only these two terms now. Expectation of x square is nothing but summation of x square into p of x values. So, once again, refer your individual table. X square into p of x. I am showing you the individual table again. Here. X square into p of x. So 1 square into 1 by 2. Plus 5 square into 1 by 2. So you get 1 into half plus 25 into half. Correct? Let me check it. Yes. 1 into half plus 25 into half. Calculate. You get the answer 13. Similarly, refer the y table. Individual table for y. Find expectation of y square, summation of all y square values into p of y values. You can here f of yj is written, it is nothing but p of yj, probability, individual probability. I'll show you the table once. For y table, here expectation of y square are obtained by minus 4 whole square into 3 by 8 plus 2 square into 3 by 8 plus 7 square into 1 by 4, correct? So using this calculation, you get expectation of x square equal to 79 by 4. Just verify yourself, all the entries. Now you got expectation of x square and expectation of y square. Substitute here. You get sigma x square and sigma y square. So sigma x square becomes 13 minus 3 square. This is your mu x term. Answer is 4. Similarly, sigma y square equal to expectation of y square minus expectation of y whole square. Answer gives you 75 by 4. Find the square root of these two. It gives you sigma x and sigma y. Sigma x is 2 and sigma y is 4.33. Now you can easily find coefficient of correlation rho xy. pro xy is given by covariance of xy divided by sigma x into sigma y. Substitute all the terms which you have calculated. You get the answer minus 0.1732. Now let us go to the next problem. The joint distribution of two random variables x and y is as follows. X values and y values are given. X values are 2, 4, 6 and y values are 1, 3, 9. And corresponding joint probabilities are given. Determine marginal distribution of x and y. Covariance of x and y. Now, how to find marginal distribution of x and y? Marginal distributions are nothing but individual probabilities, correct? So, to find individual probabilities of only x, we add the entries in front of your x values. And to find the marginal distribution of y, we add the entries below the corresponding y values. So, I have written the procedure here. For x equal to 2, add these three entries. 1 by 8 plus 1 by 24 plus 1 by 12, which gives you 1 by 4. Similarly, for x equal to 4, 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4, which gives you 1 by 2. For x equal to 6, add these three entries, 1 by 8 and 1 by 24 and 1 by 12, which gives you 1 by 4. So, for all the three values of x, we obtained the marginal densities, correct? You can verify whether your answer is correct. Add these three answers for all values of x, the answers which you obtained, probabilities, add them, answer will be equal to 1. Same procedure for y values. Start from the first value of y, y equal to 1. Okay, 1 by 8 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8, which gives you 1 by 2. Similarly, this addition, 1 by 24 plus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 24, that is for y equal to 3, it gives you 1 by 3. And the last value for y equal to 9, 1 by 12 plus 0 plus 1 by 12, which gives you 1 by 6. Okay, so it is always easy to use this procedure from the table only, instead of remembering the formula. Okay. So, individual probabilities are written here. Just verify. The probabilities which you have obtained here are written in a table. For x values 2, 4, 6, these are the probabilities obtained. For y values 1, 3, 9, these are the probabilities obtained. You can add and check the answer. Answer, some of the probabilities of y value should be equal to 1. Some of the probabilities of x values will be 1. Now, what is the next question? Covariance of x and y. Okay, you can write the covariance formula first, then you will come to know which of the terms are required. Covariance formula is this, but you cannot directly use this formula now because you don't know expectation of xy, expectation of x and expectation of y. So, calculate these terms now. What is the formula for expectation of x? It is sum of x into p of x, correct? So, no need to refer your joint distribution table now, refer only this individual table. X into p of x, 2 into 1 by 4. Plus 4 into 1 by 2 plus 6 into 1 by 4, which gives you the answer 4. So, mu x is 4. Similarly, find mu y. Summation of all y into p of y values, 1 into 1 by 2 plus 3 into 1 by 3 plus 9 into 1 by 6, which gives you the answer 3. Now, expectation of xy. For this, we need joint distribution table. What is the formula for expectation of xy? X into y into p of xy or xi into yj into p of xi yj. So go to the table, joint table, select x value 2, y value 1 and corresponding p of xi xy value 1 by 8. 2 into 1 into 1 by 8 plus 2 into 3 into 1 by 24 plus 2 into 9 into 1 by 12. Okay, like this. Select x value, select corresponding y value and the probability in the intersection of these two, row and column. For x equal to 4 and y equal to 1, intersection probability is 1 by 4. So continue this procedure. So how many entries you have totally? 9 entries, correct? So 9 such terms. Check it. You can again, you can refer the joint distribution table and verify. So each x value, corresponding y value and corresponding joint density value. Calculate this, you get the answer 12. Now covariance of xy is expectation of xy minus mu x into mu y. That means 12 minus 4 into 3, which gives you the answer 0. So very simple question. Just you have to understand how to use the method. They may give you some different table of joint table of probabilities, but this is the procedure. So I think you understood already. We worked out two problems of this type now. Let us go to the next type of question. If x and y are independent random variables, x takes values 2, 5, 7 with the probability 1 by 2, 1 by 4 and 1 by 4 respectively. Y takes values 3, 4, 5 with the probabilities 1 by 3, 1 by 3, 1 by 3. Find the joint probability distribution of x and y. Show that covariance of x and y is equal to 0. Find the probability distribution of z equal to x plus y. Now it is given that x and y are independent variables and values taken by x and corresponding probabilities are given. So what you can do now? Using this data, prepare a table. Values of x 257 and corresponding probabilities 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 4 respectively. Prepare the table. This is nothing but marginal distribution table or individual probabilities of x. Similarly, second condition, y takes the values 3, 4, 5 with the probability 1 by 3, 1 by 3, 1 by 3 respectively. So prepare this table only for y now. This is nothing but individual table for y, single random variable y, 3, 4, 5 with these three probabilities. So here this is slight different question from your previous problem. In the previous problem, joint probabilities are given and they asked individual probabilities. But here reverse, individual probabilities are given, they asked joint probabilities. But remember, from individual to joint, you can find the probability only with this condition. Condition is given, x and y are independent random variables. When you say that x and y are independent random variables, if product of individual probabilities is equal to joint probability, then only x and y are independent. So since this condition is given, we can find the joint probabilities by multiplying the individual probabilities. So in the joint distribution table, you can prepare the row headings as 257. That means under x value, you write 257. And in front of y value, you write 345. How to decide the joint probability corresponding to x equal to 2 and y equal to 3? That is multiplication of 1 by 2 into 1 by 3. Similarly, for x equal to 2 and y equal to 4, probabilities obtained by multiplying 1 by 2 and 1 by 3. So multiply the corresponding probabilities. I am showing you that procedure here. P of x equal to 2 comma y equal to 3. This is joint probability. It is given by P of x equal to 2 into P of y equal to 3. Multiply. You get the answer 1 by 6. Okay. How to select P of x equal to 2 and P of y equal to 3? That is from the individual table. This value. P of x equal to 2, 1 by 2. And P of y equal to 3, 1 by 3. 1 by 2 into 1 by 3, you get 1 by 6. Similarly, for other possibilities, when x equal to 2 and y equal to 4, you get P of x equal to 2 into P of y equal to 4. Multiply and find the product. You get 1 by 6. Similarly, P of x equal to 2 and P of y equal to 5, multiply the probabilities, you get 1 by 6. Continue this procedure for all the entries. Totally how many entries? 3 into 3, 9 entries, correct? Continue this procedure for all entries. Just verify this. Verify the products. and after finding all the answers, you get this table. You can write this table. X values are 257 and Y values are 345. Write the table, the values which you have obtained just now. This is P of X equal to 2 comma Y equal to 3, joint probability. P of X equal to 2, Y equal to 4, joint probability. Continue this, and finally, this column sum or this row sum should be equal to 1. Okay, column sum equal to 1 as well as row sum equal to 1. Okay, these are nothing but, you can just verify, this is already given under individual probabilities, 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 1 by 4. You can add and verify. Here you know how to find the marginal probabilities from the joint table, correct? You can add these entries and check it. 1 by 6 plus 1 by 6 plus 1 by 6, you get 3 by 6, which is 1 by 2. Continue this. Already these probabilities are given. Just verify in your individual tables. These are given. Okay. So we obtained the joint PDF of X and Y. First question. Second question. Show that covariance is 0. Let me verify it. If X and Y are independent, always covariance will be 0. Okay, remember. Here it is already given in the question. X and Y are independent. We will get covariance as 0, but we will verify it. What is the formula for covariance? Expectation of XY minus mu X into mu Y. Mu X is given by summation of X into P of X values. Now, it is enough if you refer only individual tables which you have written in the beginning. You know the procedure, correct? I need not have to explain much. Just multiply X values with the corresponding P of X values. You get the answer 4. Mu Y. Refer the individual distribution table for Y. From that, Y into P of Y values. Okay, YJ into P of YJ or YI into P of YI or Y into P of Y. You can use any notation, but understand the method. You get the answer 4. Expectation of XY. For this, you need to refer joint table. Just now you obtained this table. Okay, how to find expectation of XY? X into Y into P of XY. So 2 into 3 into 1 by 6 plus 2 into 4 into 1 by 6 plus 2 into 5 into 1 by 6. Continue this procedure. And remember, don't include this in your expectation of XY. This is your marginal probabilities. Only till here you have to. Only 3 into 3, 9 entries. Okay, don't include your marginal probabilities while multiplying. Only this X into Y into P of XY. Continue, you get the answer 16. Verify it. Write every entry in your notes. Calculate and verify. Don't simply write down. Now, what is the covariance formula? Expectation of XY minus mu X mu Y. Substitute, you get the answer 0. Now, third question. Find the distribution of, what is your third question? Find the distribution of Z equal to X plus Y. So, find the distribution. Which are the possible values of X and Y? Refer your X and Y values. Okay, for each possible X and Y values, find the sum. Okay, you get, which of the possibilities are there to get the sum? 5, 6, 7, 8, these are the sum values, addition. Each X value and Y value are added and you have written the sum here. Now for this sum, to get X equal to 5 as the sum equal to 5, which are the values of X and Y and what is the corresponding probability? That you have to verify from the joint table. Okay, when X equal to, sum equal to 5, sum is 5 means you have to select X equal to 2 and Y equal to 3. So sum is 5 means X is 2 and Y is 3. Which is the probability? 1 by 6. Just we select the probability and write here. 1 by 6. For sum equal to 6, what is the possibility? You get sum equal to 6 when X is 2 and Y is 4, right? No other possibility. So what is the probability? 1 by 6. Continue like this. For example, to get sum equal to 11, what is the probability? Sum is 11 if you are adding 7 and 4, right? 7 and 4. That means corresponding probability is 1 by 12. So this is the procedure to write the probabilities here. Probabilities of sum. Okay. I'll give you one more similar problem just for your practice. X and Y are independent random variables. X takes the values 1, 2 with probability 0.7, 0.3 each. and y takes the values minus 2, 5, 8 with the probabilities 0.3, 0.5, 0.2. Okay, so individual probabilities are given. X values and corresponding probabilities are given. Write them in a table. Similarly, y values minus 2, 5, 8 with the corresponding probabilities are given. Prepare a table. So these are individual probabilities. And given that x and y are independent random variables, so you can find the distribution of joint distribution of x and y easily. What is the condition for joint distribution to be independent? If x and y are independent, then joint distribution will be equal to p of xi into p of yj. Multiply the corresponding probabilities. Okay. So to find the joint distribution, I have shown you the procedure here. P of 1 comma minus 2. I think you can understand this notation. That means x equal to 1 and y equal to minus 2. Refer this table. X equal to 1 and y equal to minus 2 means 0.7 into 0.3. Multiply the entries. You get 0.21. Similarly, x equal to 1, y equal to 5. Multiply the corresponding probabilities from the individual table. X equal to 1, y equal to 8. You get this. X equal to 2, y equal to minus 2. So when you complete this procedure, write these entries in the joint distribution table. Okay. So totally how many entries? 2, 5, 2, 8. Totally 6 entries, right? 3 here and 3 here. Totally 6 entries. So these 6 entries. Now you can just verify. Already this is given. Individual probabilities are given. Just verify by continuing one more column in this table. Add these entries and check the sum, whether it is 0.7. Add these entries in front of your x equal to 2. Add the entries and check the sum, whether it is 0.3. Okay, if the answers are correct, 0.7 and 0.3, that means your calculation is correct. Similarly, below the columns corresponding to minus 2, 5 and 8, add the entries and check whether this is the answer. These column entries, add and check it. Okay, these two column entries, add and check it. So this is nothing but individual probability of y. Already it is given, you just verify here. And sum under this row should be, this column should be 1, and sum of these entries in the row will be again equal to 1. Just verify this sum is this column sum or row sum, this one. Now what is the next question? Covariance of xy. To find covariance of xy, we need expectation of xy minus expectation of x into expectation of y. Find expectation of x only. Now first find only mu x. For that only individual table is enough. Summation of x into p of xi. Okay. Or how to refer this table? If you are not referring the individual table, how to refer this table? X values are here and p of x values are your marginal values. So 1 into 0.7 plus 2 into 0.3. Calculate. So either refer individual table or here refer only the first column and last column. Marginal probabilities. Answer is 1.3. Similarly, find mu y, expectation of y. So multiply y with the p of y. So minus 2, y is here, p of y is here. Minus 2 into 0.3 plus 5 into 0.5 plus 8 into 0.2. So you get 3.5. And for this you need to refer joint distribution table. Expectation of xy is given by x summation of x into y into p of xy. So multiply. So 1 into minus 2 into 0.21 plus 1 into 5 into 0.35 plus 1 into 8 into 0.14. It continues like this. Okay. So how many entries totally? 6 entries. Check your calculation. I have just written the products here. Just verify yourself. Finally, when you calculate this, totally 6 entries, correct? You will get 4.55. You can use your own method to calculate this. Now, once if you have expectation of xy, mu x and mu y, you can find covariance of xy, which is 4.55 minus, that means expectation of xy minus expectation of x into expectation of y. Answer is 0. Remember, always if x and y are independent, covariance will be 0. Here they asked you to verify, so we verified the result. Answer is 0, correct. So I think now we worked out 4 problems. First 2 problems, in first 2 problems they have given joint probabilities and they asked you to find individual probabilities. In third and fourth question, they have given individual probabilities with the condition that x and y are independent. Using that condition, we obtained the joint probabilities. And remember, if x and y are not independent, you cannot use individual probabilities to find the joint probability. Okay. So in the next session, I will give you again some different types of problems. Okay. Here I will stop now. Thank you.